It was now about noon, and darkness came over the whole land until 3 in the afternoon, because of an eclipse of the sun. Then the veil of the temple was torn down the middle. Jesus cried out in a loud voice, "Father, into your hands I commend my spirit." And when he had said this, he breathed his last.
What? My legs feel good. These beautiful angels. Could it be heaven? Yes. Yes, I think it's heaven. Oh, how I've longed for heaven. When I gave my life to Jesus, I knew that I'd get to spend eternity in heaven with Jesus. And look, there's the angel of the Lamb's Book of Life. You know, when you're saved, your name is written in the Lamb's Book of Life. Angel, my name is Leah. Is my name in the Lamb's Book of Life?
Me too, buddy. That was literally the best decision you could ever make. And just think, you didn't want to get out of bed this morning, and now you're a born-again Christian. Love you so much, buddy.
I love you too.
Love you guys too. Y'all are right. I'm so glad I got out of bed this morning. And this is the best decision I've ever made. That makes me think about Jordan. She got saved too. Does that mean we'll see her in heaven one day?
Yes, son, of course. That's why your salvation is so important to your mother and I. One of these days we'll all be reunited with your sister in heaven, and we're going to get to spend eternity together, buddy. And it's all because of the grace of God. This is such a big day for our family.
Yes, I can't wait for all four of us to be together again. We need to celebrate. Jeremiah, what do you want to do for lunch?
Devil, go! Oh!
Buddy, it looks like we're in heaven. It's mesmerizing. The clouds, they're so beautiful. And look at the streets. The streets really are made of gold.
It is heaven. It's so beautiful.
Dad, look at the angels. They're so majestic.
Honey, we need to find Jordan. I need to see my baby girl. We need to get through that gate.
Excuse me. Angel, is that the Lamb's Book of Life? We're the Alvarado family, and our names must be in that book. We've all accepted Jesus Christ as our Lord and Savior, and we're looking for our daughter, Jordan.
Someone had to save you? What happened?
saw. Just what I meant was I asked Jesus into my heart. Now my name is Winston and I'm still alive.
Oh, okay, whatever.
Also, my friend asked if I wanted to go to church with him on Sunday.
Well, you know, Marshall, that's all fine and good every once in a while. You know, you don't have to go to church to be a Christian, right? That's just one of those things they make you believe you gotta be there every Sunday. You know, it's not that big a deal. You don't have to go sit in the third row and the pew every Sunday and sit next to all those Bible thumpers and holy rollers. I don't mind if you go once in a while, but not, I'm not gonna get up every Sunday morning at the crack of dawn when it's my one and only day off.
Well, are you a Christian?
Well, I mean, I've been to church, and I guess God's probably real. I mean, I've never said no sinner's prayer or nothing, but I'm a good person. I'm sure, yeah, probably.
Well, have you ever accepted Jesus in your heart?
All these questions. Well, Marshall, what you don't understand, because you're just a kid, is that the idea of being a Christian is way complicated. I mean, it's so hard. They expect you to follow all these five commandments and, like, you know, the whole don't murder, don't steal part of it. Everybody's got that. That's fine. But the rest of them, they expect you to live a perfect life, 365 days. It's impossible. Nobody can live up to those standards. But, you know, I'm a good person. I'm good. I know I'm good.
Well, actually, there's 10 commandments, but my teacher also said that it's easy, just like the ABCs. A, admit that you're a sinner. B, believe that Jesus is your Lord and Savior, and that he rose again on the third day. And C, call upon him and you'll be saved.
I don't know about all that. That sounds like a bunch of kid stuff to me, you know? It's way more complicated. Those 10 commandments, I know it says it's way more complicated than that. I've been to a church enough times to know it's way more complicated than that. Besides, hold on, I gotta text your dad and let him know that we're on the way.
Mom, watch out!
Life, that he got saved.
good person. I don't cheat on my taxes. I donate to Christian Helping Hands. And heck, with that last fundraiser they had at the church, with all the cupcakes I sold, I practically paid for that new addition. I've definitely earned my way to get in there. Hey, you lady up there, is your name Angel? With that book. My name is Brenda. My son's already in there. Can you let me just let these, tell these ladies to let me through? My name's gotta be in that book. What's over there?
Church and go to the altar.
No, and you know what? Let me ask my husband if
mean, we'll just say it out loud, and, you know, you're a born-again believer, and you'll go to heaven and know that, you know.
I would love it. I really feel like God's calling me to do that.
Okay, hey. Can you pray with us?
This can be embarrassing. Hold on.
Yeah.
Hey, Sturgis, can we get another drink? You don't have to have that after this.
So, just repeat after me.
Hey, you want one?
Okay. Dear Lord Jesus.
Dear Lord Jesus.
I know that I am a sinner.
I know that I am a sinner.
And I ask for your forgiveness.
And I ask for your forgiveness.
I believe you died for my sins.
I believe you died for my sins.
And rose from the dead.
And rose from the dead.
I turn from my sins.
I turn from my sins.
And invite you to come into my heart.
And invite you to come into my heart.
I want to trust and follow you as my Lord and Savior.
I want to trust and follow you as my Lord and Savior.
In Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen. That's crazy, the feeling that I have. It's like a sense of peace.
I know.
And to think I put it off that long just because I thought it was too hard.
It's really that easy, and there's just this weight lifted off of you.
Thank you.
I'll definitely see you guys Sunday.
Oh, good.
Thank you guys so much.
You look good.
What's happening?
For our area. Be alert for sudden changes in water levels and seek higher ground for safety.
Hey, buddy. Sure glad You said I'd go fishing with me tonight, and I sacked him up here last week. You used to go with me all the time on Wednesday nights. You don't go with me no more.
Yes, Dad, me too. But I like going to church more.
Going to church more? Why would you like to go to church more than fishing?
Well, ever since I got saved at Falls Creek, I just wanted to know more about Jesus and his love.
Falls Creek, yeah, I remember Falls Creek. Them were some fun times. Went there, hung out with all my friends, played all the sports and everything. Man, it was a lot of fun, met a lot of people. But I wasn't real keen on the church stuff and everything. But you said something about being saved. What do you mean about being saved?
Well, I asked Jesus in my heart and I'm going to heaven. Are you?
Well, I mean, yeah, I've been a good person my whole life. I mean, I've always involved in community and always help out, always pay it forward and give, and don't ever do nothing bad. Surely God would send somebody to help a new person.
No, you have to ask him into your heart to go to heaven.
You got to ask him in your heart. How do you do that?
It's a simple prayer.
A simple prayer? Well, you know, I don't, you know, like I said, Wednesday's my only night off to go. I mean, you know how much I like fishing, but Sunday mornings, I mean, I've got to catch up on my chores Sunday mornings. It's the only 2 days I have off, you know, so I ain't got really time to go to church and stuff like that.
You don't have to go to church to say it.
You don't have to go to church?
No, you can do it now.
Just with a prayer? Mm-hmm. So I just got to ask Jesus in my heart and he'll just accept me and I don't have to do that. Okay. Well, can I say the prayer now? Can you pray with me?
Mm-hmm.
Jesus, I know I'm a sinner. I ask you to come into my heart and forgive me my sins. And I ask this, if you would please. Amen. Man, buddy, is that, wow. Is that the kind of thing that you had when you said the prayer and everything?
Yes, just the Holy Spirit.
Oh man, I don't think I've ever, man, I feel like I could swim across this lake right now. My good, I tell you what, from now on, we'll find another time to go fishing and I can do my chores. I'm gonna go to church with you, Mom, from now on. I appreciate this. Thank you, buddy. Man, it's been great. Well, there's a storm moving in. We probably need to go get him down right now. Let me start this boat.
Same thing talks about being real, Macy.
I'm not doing that.
Well, if you're not going to be fun with us, then you can leave. How about
okay.
That?
Okay then, bye.
Bye.
Go back and tell them you will have fun, buddy Nutty.
Yes.
Come on.
Let's do it.
I don't know. I'm not young enough now. You know what? It's nothing. It's not getting too big. It's fine. It's just, it's a little drug. It's nothing too big.
Okay, I trust you though. Can you drop it? I know what you're doing.
I know what I'm doing. Come on, give me your hand.
It's going to be so much fun.
Okay?
Okay.
Ready?
Go.
Hey, you too! Come on! We're coming back for her. I may be coming for a few of you, too.
Jesus himself. Please, please let me talk to him. Hi, I'm Taylor. You know me, and I know you. You know, my dad's a preacher, and I went to all the Sunday schools, I went to all the Wednesday nights, I went to all the church activities, Falls Creek. I've read the Bible several times, so I know it. I don't think I deserve to go down there. I think I deserve to go up there with you, please.
Taylor, I've tried many, many times to reach you. Just because you know who I am does not mean that you know me. Depart from me, for I never knew you.
No, please don't. Please don't do this to me. Please no. Please turn back around. I don't want to do this. Please no. Please come back.
His little girl gets to spend eternity in hell. Ah! Taylor.
No, I don't.
You thought you knew Jesus? Taylor, even I know who Jesus is. But like you, I didn't believe in it either. She's yours, boys! Get her out of here!
Today. Don't worry about your family. Don't let them get in your head. Don't worry about your friends. You got your life back today. You can do whatever you want. You have no responsibilities. And you can start life all over today. Don't let your family bring you down. You made the right decision today for you.
Hey, Dad, how are you? How am I? Yeah, well, Jesse, if you ask me how I'm doing, I'm stuck in this wheelchair, hooked up to these IVs.
It's been a rough day, huh?
Rough day? Rough week? Rough life?
Well, have you given any more thought, you know, about what we've been talking about? God, and, you know, asking Him
no, in your heart? I don't want to hear any of that. I know you're a preacher, and that's what you do out in life and stuff, but I don't want to hear that.
You know, Dad, if you'd ask God into your heart, He could help you with that pain, that all that stuff that you're going through. He could comfort you, Dad.
No, He can't do that.
Dad, all you got to do is ask Him and believe in your heart that He can help.
No, He can't forgive me. There's stuff I've done in my past that you don't even know about.
Dad, that's what's so awesome about God. He forgets about that. You know how... You won't remember that no more. From the east to the west,
son,
it's all gone.
I don't want to hear about that. That's your life, not mine. I just want to be left alone.
Dad, would you at least let me pray for you?
No, I don't want to hear about your prayer. Just we'll pray for someone else.
Okay, Dad, I want to go. But I want to come back tomorrow. And we're going to talk about God some more.
I guess I'll see you tomorrow.
Okay, Dad. I love you.
Nurse! Prayers or anything from him to get up here, huh? Didn't need church, didn't need nothing like that. Well, that must be that angel he was telling me about one time, the Lamb's Book of Life. Hey, my name's Dennis. Am I in that Book of Life? Tell me, come on, tell me. I ain't got all day. Let's go. What does that mean?
thank you folks for coming to my dad's memorial service today. You know, Dad was a good man. But you know, there was one thing that defined him. He could not forgive himself of his sins. He could not forgive himself of his past. He thought there was no way he could be forgiven. But folks, I'm here to tell you, we live for an almighty, loving, forgiving, awesome God. We live for a God that can forgive us of our sins. We live for a God that can forgive us of our past. Stuff that we done that we thought there was no way or nobody could forgive us. And folks, if there's one thing that I want y'all to remember when you leave this service today is, I want you to know who your Lord and Savior is. I don't want any doubt in your mind that you're going to heaven. Because folks, we are guaranteed nothing in this life except death. We are all guaranteed to die. Our small community this year has seen a lot of tragedies, from plane crashes to car accidents to families losing children. And folks, if we want to see those people in heaven, we have got to make sure we have God in our heart. Because folks, I don't know when the rapture is going to happen. I don't know when Jesus is coming back. But it is written in God's word that when Jesus is coming back, it's going to be in the blink of an eye. Folks, the blink of an eye is about this fast.
My heart feels, oh, I dance for you, Jesus. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. Amen. You know, that's real life stories that we live today in this world we live in. It's so easy to live life and never have anything to do with the Lord Jesus Christ. It's easy. But unless your name and my name is written in the Lamb's Book of Life, there'll be no way we go to heaven. No way. Some people get the idea that they can work their way into it. God says, no, you can't. Some people think they've done too much wrong stuff in their life, from having abortions to whatever. You know, the God we serve, like Dal said, is a forgiving God. And He wants to forgive people. The Bible says we've all sinned and fall short of the glory of God. That's who we are. But we got a perfect God, a perfect Savior, that went to the cross of Calvary that day and hung on the cross. He took all the anger of God. He took all of our sins and hung on that cross that day. When He breathed His last, He said, it's finished. I've done everything God, Jesus said, I've done everything God and the Father wanted me to do. And I bear all your sins on my body tonight. He was buried in the grave and He resurrected the third day. I don't know why you or me deserve to go to heaven, because we don't. But by the grace of God, we get to go by asking Jesus Christ into our heart to forgive us of our sins. But we've got to do it. You know, so many people, like myself, is a procrastinate, and I'll do it tomorrow. I'll do it next week. I'll do it when I get back to some other church. I'll do it whenever. People, we don't have no idea when and ever it's going to come. The Bible says today is an accepted time. Today is the day of salvation. The Bible is also real plain about something. It said, let the Holy Spirit of God draw the man, he can't be saved. And I've had people ask me, today, how do you know when the Holy Spirit is drawing you? This is my answer. How do you know when you're hungry? How do you know when you're thirsty? You'll know without a shadow of a doubt that the Holy Spirit's calling you, and He's calling you for a specific reason, and that's to give your life to the Lord Jesus Christ. I don't know if anybody looked around lately in the world you and I live in, but this world you and I live in is not going to last long. It really and truly ain't. One of these days, every one of us is going to stand in front of God. The Bible said that every knee will bow and every tongue confess that Jesus Christ is Lord. But what's most important about that statement is, if we do it on this earth, if we confess the Lord Jesus Christ on this earth, we get to go to heaven. If we wait to stand in front of God and bow our knee then, we get to go to hell. The great thing about God is we get to make the choice. Amen. And I believe the Holy Spirit draws all men once. Somebody say, well, I've been living all my life and I've been going to church all my life. I'm just too old. I'm just this, I'm just that. No, you're not. You're who God wanted you to be. And maybe tonight, maybe just tonight, He's calling you to come and give your life to Him. There's nothing like it, believe me. I had a burden on myself so hard when I was 38 years old. And I asked Jesus Christ in my heart, and that burden left immediately. And I've been so blessed since then. I've struggled, don't get me wrong. But God has always been with me all my days since then. And He always will be. Amen. He always will be. Yeah. I'm asking you tonight. We do this for a reason. Because there's people that need to be saved. Last year before last, we done it, 60-something people give their life to the Lord through this plane. And we always give God all the glory. We receive nothing. God gets all the glory. But I'm asking you tonight, if you're sitting in that pew and you feel something kind of pulling on you a little bit, you feel something saying, hey, you need to get up and you need to give your life to the Lord, that's the Holy Spirit calling you. And Jesus wants to do something in your life tonight. If you're that person, don't let that person next to you make you feel like, well, don't worry about that person next to you. God is calling you wherever you're at in this building tonight. Have you received the Lord Jesus Christ? Is your name written in the Lamb's Book of Life, where it'll never be erased once it's written down? I'm asking you, have you ever really and truly trusted the Lord Jesus Christ? If you hadn't, I would love to share with you. I will not embarrass you, no way, fashion, form. I'm not going to ask you to pray to no one. I just want to share with you how simple it is to be saved. That's who God is. He showed us His love on the cross of Calvary. He showed it to us. Will you accept it tonight?